Hi, I've started this project for the second bedroom in my house using this mask, which my son brought out years ago from his high school after he finished it as a project. Now, I'm using this mask because I've created a kind of design thinking that it's like a mystic creature underneath the water, like a prince or kelp prince that you can imagine that lives underneath the water. And for this project, I have used few templates and put them together to give me the length for the entire wall. In a minute, I will show you the procedure, how you can achieve this type of 3D work art. And definitely, of course, using your own imagination, you can improve it greatly, or you can do anything else like an idea of yours on any walls that you have in your house or bathroom, for example, in this instance. I've drawn on a piece of paper a kind of template, so I'm going just to cut it roughly. And for the 3D art itself, you can use like, for example, I'm using a thickness of the 3D product, like 1/8 of an inch or the half an of centimeter, and that is up to you entirely. The idea is to stand out from the wall in a manner that is not going to look ugly or is not going to obstruct the view, or of course you can manage the thickness. So this is, as I said, a roughly template that I cut, and I'm going to show you how you can finish the design. So I have here for the one that I showed you already, I made few templates, and those are a little bit much more complex, but I'm not going to show you how you can do it, because again, this is my idea, this is my desire in this design. You have another idea, of course, so it's not useful for you to understand exactly what I'm doing here, because it's exactly my idea for this design for the bathroom. So those are few templates that I put them together actually in the bathroom. So you will see it has like a fluence in the movement on the wall. So you can just attach every single template, one close to another or different position at one point, turn them on the wall, and you can achieve the 3D wall art that I have finished on the wall for the bathroom. This little template, it's useful for me to finish the ends of this bigger template. So I'm going to show you how you can do it. So first you will start with, I'm using this, it's a drywall, like for anything that you wish to use a drywall. It's a very cheap product. You don't have to spend a lot of money for it. And I'm getting a block like this one and a little bit more. The idea is to have like that 1 inch thickness, to reach that 1 inch thickness, and also you need the surface to have it enough for the template to cut it from the drywall. So I'm just trying to spread a little bit this drywall here. And for the rest of it, I'm coming with another piece of plastic. You can use a plastic bag or any other plastic, doesn't matter. And again, push it down a little bit as you wish to reach that thickness, as I mentioned, an eighth of an inch in my case, or half of a centimeter. And also you have to check if you have enough surface for your template. So here I got it. I'm going to remove the first layer of the plastic. And here for the surface, to make it smoother, I'm using this spatula, and I'm just going to make it a little bit smoother to look in the way that I like it. Of course, you can leave it with bigger holes or another texture, it's up to you. So I'm going to place this template on top. I'm trying to push it a little bit down just to make the contact with the surface. And I'm trying now to remove the drywall that I don't need it. So I'm just trying to remove on this spatula and get it back to the pail, because I will use it for another project later. So you'll go all the way around. So this is the way that looks one of the templates that is dry, and I'm trying to attach this piece here somewhere, kind of. And for this, I'm just going to put some silicone on it. I'm using the cheapest one on the market. You don't have to invest too much money in this project. The idea is to get a wow effect with not using too much as expenses. So I'm just trying to squeeze here some silicone, and that is going to help me to attach this piece on the wall. You have to just spread it here and there to make sure that stays firmly on the wall, and just place it in exactly the way that you wish to look for your design. So I'm going to use it like this one. Gently, I will just place it here and tap it and put it here, like it's going to stick. Now, if you wish to continue to make it more elaborate, a 3D wall art, you can just make all the templates one by one. You can attach them in different ways, and gives you the impression that are like one piece. So I will show in a minute the final look of the entire bathroom 3D wall art. So this is the finished look of my project. So again, started from the mask that I had it, but again, you can use any template or anything that imagination goes with. And I try to attach like small pieces, one close to another, to give the impression that are like all one piece. And I started to build up over the door, and I came on the other side here too. Again, they will have always contact, all the branches one to another. So this is like one piece. This is the last one that I showed you. And you can use here a little bit more drywall, and that is going to be put here a little bit later. And to make the connection with the rest of the piece. And here you can see the thickness of the piece and the way that looks on the wall. So this is one of the biggest templates that I used. And on top, it's a second one. But you can make it from small pieces, and together they will give you the same effect. So this is the finish look of the bathroom. And again, I'm extremely pleased the way that looks. And I hope that was an inspiration for you as well to start your own 3D wall art. Because again, it's not hard to be done. Just again, little bit imagination and patience. And that it's the way that you can achieve this type of 3D wall art. Entire cost for the whole bathroom was $30. So I think that is well worth it, the effect that I've created in this small space. I'm not using any design here where the towels will be hung, because it's not point in that, and that's why I have the space between. But the rest of it has fluence, so it's going to have like continuity all the way around. So definitely it's not hard to be done, and definitely can bring so much joy to you. Thank you for being part of this project. I wish you good luck and goodbye.